that's all we're going to talk about in terms of HMMs and gesture. I'll say the good things about it were it was a learning paradigm, right? So you define some features. By the way, you have to define the right features. You collect some well-annotated data, which also takes some work. But given that, you're able to train your HMMs by just giving it the data. So it's a learning paradigm, and that's good. The training is a little bit slow. It's not very slow, but recognition can be very fast because of that recursive, those recursive algorithms we talked about. Running those is very quick. So that works really well. You know, of course, not everything is perfect. They're not as good for segmentation labeling as some newer methods. I mentioned conditional random fields earlier. If you actually have something where your training data has particular underlying states and you know what those states are, so it's not even really a hidden Markov model. It is a Markov model, but your training data, you know the underlying states, and you're seeing an observation and you want that state sequence for that segmentation, there are now better methods, and I mentioned conditional random fields. You know, in general, this stuff requires a reasonable amount of data to train. One of the reasons it was used for speech is we had lots and lots and lots of data. Although I will say that HMMs may require less data than some of these more discriminative methods. And then I put down something that I think is tautological, but also important to know. I said it works well when the problem is easy. We did a lot of work on HMMs, gesture, et cetera, whatever. And it's very powerful for capturing regularities when the regularities are quite clear. You have to do a lot more work on your feature selection and a bunch of other things when those differences are a little bit harder to see, number of states and those kinds of things. So, you know, that's probably true of most classification methods. When the problem is easy, they all work great. It's when the problem is not so easy that the challenge comes in, and that's when people start reporting on small differences. That means the real issue in choosing your classifier is to understand where the complexity and where the difficulty of your problem is. But in general, people still use HMMs a lot, and they use it for describing activity or time series. And you know, it's in some sense your first line of defense against activity recognition.